It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the boys and the Niners. And it comes your way next.
We are about 40 miles or so south of Candlestick Point at a place that first opened back in 2014. As you get a look at Levi's Stadium here in Santa Clara, California. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Dallas Cowboys and the San Francisco 49ers. And a welcome in, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden, and Charles, so much gets made about offensive comparisons. Here's a matchup where the defenses may just take center stage.
Yeah, we're usually talking about guys scoring touchdowns. How about the guys who prevent them and change the momentum of the game when they take the ball away? I love those ball hawks in the secondary. People after my own heart.
It's the team of the 80s versus the team of the 90s. The Niners, the Cowboys, they're underway. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. They'll be led out by Mr. Irrelevant in the 2022 draft, a guy with something to prove, Iowa State's career passing leader. And that's Brock Purdy.
For every rookie prospect, there are always nerves involved in this moment. Running your team out to start a game. But there's a reason they brought him in. We're willing to make him their starter today. They believe he can overcome those nerves and lead his team to a victory. We saw him do it at the collegiate level and really make himself into a leader and someone you can envision doing the exact same thing here in the NFL.
And trying to get it to Samuel, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Nashawn Wright. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football.
Wow, just one snap in, partner, and the complexion of this game has already changed because for the defensive side, they just handed their offense a short field and a big early advantage. And even though it's only the first snap of the game, we're going to look back on this one and see if it has lasting effects as this game moves on.
First look at the Cowboys offense as Dak Prescott gets ready to guide them.
And what he's thinking about right now is first down, let's find a way to make a big play. Because when you get a sudden change situation and that defense has to rush onto the field unexpectedly, you might catch them having a defensive breakdown or not quite prepared.
And it was really sudden after the first play picked off. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Following the interception, here's Prescott. He finds his target. It's Schultz. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days, but you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred the defense.
And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. And they'll keep leaning on the running game, back to the ground. Oh, and fine work there as he gets this thing down to the 11-yard line. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. They go to Elliott again. Oh, a good move at the 5. And able to get him inside the 5 here, just inside the 5 to about the 4. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Inside give to Elliott. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll try and run for it with Allen, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Well, first quarter, maybe too early to talk about statement drives, Charles, but that sure seemed like a statement drive right there.
Well, if we're going to talk about statement drives, I think what they're saying is we're going to establish the run. They gave it to him early and often on this drive, and he wound up taking it into the end zone.
Brett Maher on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys. That time a 6-play drive, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Following the touchdown, here's Maher to kick it away. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. Back out there comes the 49ers offense, ready for their 2nd drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number 2?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
That good for 22 and a 1st down.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle. Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ended up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. They'll go option to the short side, and he is going to lose yardage here. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package, and that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on 2nd down and 11. Back to throw, Purdy. He'll get this to Jennings over the middle. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher. Guys trying to
get it to Samuel, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
Well, that's what you get, apparently, when you try to take on a Pro Bowl cornerback. I mean, what a play there to make the interception and also bring it back for six.
And he is so good that we've seen teams absolutely stay away from throwing the ball at him. Here, he's just reading the quarterback's eyes the entire way, makes a great play on the football, and turns it into six.
Extra point by Marr, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Now the road ahead a little bit more difficult now after that pick six. So dealing with this deficit here, we'll see if he can try to make amends on this drive, first and 10.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
End result of that one, a nice four-yard gain, so you can use that to set up your play-action game, or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
Purdy to throw it on first down. Over the middle, complete. It's Jennings. So 5 yards here, five on the play, and that'll make it second down. They run with McCaffrey off the option. They follow up the gain of five by only getting one there on second down.
Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. That makes him now 0-for-2 here in the first quarter on third down conversions.
And now they'll look to their defense, because they need them to step up so they don't fall further behind here in the early going.
On fourth down, the Niners trot out Mitch Wishnowski to punt the football. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. They've got things going their way early. 14-0 lead and the football. First and 10. Looking to throw. Prescott. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. A dump off to Elliott. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming. Let's go. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession, as they've got it with a third down coming up. Prescott to throw it. Right back to his running back, Ezekiel Elliott. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. That'll give him 8 that time, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Brandon, it certainly looked like they had that play defended well, but it still almost worked. Got it to the running back. He wound up getting really good yardage out of it, but it was third and long, and they were able to rally and stop him before he could get to the marker.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. Back deep, Ray McLeod. Yards that time on the punt, and the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. San Francisco set to go on offense once more. A last series form, a little disappointing, forced a punt, and now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Another run with McCaffrey on second down. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about 2.
Back-to-back 4-yard runs. Now, look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now 3rd and 2, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. On 3rd down, it's Purdy. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, based on what we've seen so far, I don't think you can even call this an off day anymore, partner, because this group we're watching, they are totally out of rhythm trying to get their game plan up and running. That 0 on the scoreboard is glaring down at them with every incompletion.
So on 4th down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. They start on the ground with Elliott. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. 49 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme, when you have a blocker on a defender, and then the running back can read it, find the proper hole, and just go, sometimes a thing of beauty.
Prescott on 1st down. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Up the middle, here's Elliott. Oh, nice move. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
First and 10, Prescott. And this one quickly to Lamb. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 41. Here's Prescott. Another one to CeeDee Lamb. He's got it. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run. 32 yards.
Let's face it, the focus is going to be at the end of this play on the big time gain, right? He lined up on the left and worked his way all the way to the right before the perfect pass found him. But how about the offensive line and the protection to give him enough time to work his way all the way across the field?
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. To throw is Prescott. That ball is caught. It's Gallup. Touchdown, Cowboys. 8 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Cowboys have moved out in front by 3 touchdowns. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close. And then he delivers a touchdown pass on first and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got him down close. I think that big play left him reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you? Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
Marr on for the extra point. And it is now 21-0. A drive that time of 6 plays. And it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. Fielded right around the 8. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here.
Well, CD, you kind of feel like they're in a bit of a danger zone right here, because now you're down 3 scores, and I know we're in the first half, but the way this offense hasn't been able to generate anything, you feel like they probably need to get something going on this drive, right?
Yeah, and sometimes I overuse that this is an important possession. But I think this has to be the possession where they come up with an answer, because only a few teams in league history have ever come back from a 4-score deficit. And if they don't score here, that's what they could be facing the next time they get the ball.
Here's second and 1 yard.
Off the option, here's McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
Able to get the 1 yard he needed, but nothing more.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They run with McCaffrey off the option. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. Purdy will set up to throw it here. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. They'll wind up losing 3 here on the play. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
Here's Mitch Wishnowsky now on to punt. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. Zeke and the Cowboys ready to begin their next drive. And he's well on his way to a 100-yard game. He's already more than halfway there. We're only in the second quarter.
And what I've always loved about running backs is they'll tell you, I had no idea how many yards I had.
Right.
Those guys have an innate sense of where they are in a ball game and how many yards they've accumulated, because you know they're always working towards 100.
He's been working well towards 100 here.
The object there was to get the ball to him on a quick slant, see if he could get loose and take one the distance. But the defense was prepared, and incompletion results.
Again from the 20 after the incompletion. Here's 2nd and 10. Here's Prescott. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a 1st down. Well done. Give them 15 there, and the Cowboys have a 1st.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now and light a fire under these guys. They've got to start playing better assignment football and start getting guys on the ground.
First down, Prescott. He finds his man complete. It's Schultz. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 11 more on that one, and another 1st down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the 1st down.
A 1st down throw for Prescott. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a 1st. Well, you don't become a 2-time rushing champion in this league without being able to shed some tackles. And Ezekiel Elliott does just that on this latest run.
Yeah, and this defense has had its share of problems getting guys to the ground. And here's another example. They never should have allowed this play to gain as many yards as it did, but poor tackling early in the play led to big yardage after the fact.
Prescott looks to throw on 1st. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. Touchdown, Cowboys! 2 first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys continue to pull away here in this first half.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Marr now to add the extra point. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. So the drive there, 5 plays, 80 yards.
And it's finished off by the touchdown from CeeDee Lamb.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And able to get this out to the 25. Well, the Niners going back on offense now late in this first half. And with the score where it is, even though I think they'd love to get back to the locker room, they may be forced to try and get something out of this drive. On first down, Purdy. And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Another try after the first down sack. Purdy. And he wisely will throw that one away.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And they'll indeed stop him on third down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. Here's Mitch Wishnowsky now. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And he'll be out right at the 35. Almost outkicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Final 24 seconds of the first half as they come up here first and 10. Throwing, Prescott. He finds his man, complete. It's Schultz. So the completion good for 6 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's play now. Don't stay. It's one play at a time, baby. Let's rock and roll. Let's ride.
So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman.
All right, BG, thanks very much. And welcome one and all to our beautiful new downtown Orlando studios for this EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for the Cowboys. And their offense has been in top form so far, especially their passing game, as it's helped push them out to this big halftime lead. Meanwhile, for the Niners, we check on their numbers on the ground in the first half, as they know they'll need to be better to overcome this halftime deficit.
All right, Coach, thank you very much, as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line.
Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
And it's hard to imagine that the first half could have gone any better for them, so what's the approach here in the second half?
Just continue to play smart football because they got the other team down and they feel good about the position they're in. The obvious thing people would say is just keep attacking, but I think you also have to be smart about it. Avoid turnovers. That's about the only thing that can derail you at this point. Attack, but make sure you take care of the ball.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. On play action, Prescott. Eluding the pressure right.
And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
Well, so far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Prescott. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. They'll give him 4 yards there, and that's going to make it fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Fair catch called for and taken right near the 30-yard line. 36 yards on the punt with no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half.
A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history. That's try to come back from a 4-possession deficit.
And partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible. Let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one. I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
A third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points.
And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, this is just a continuation of what we saw in the first half. So much for the fresh start to begin the third quarter. Still off-target throws, no rhythm throwing the football, and obviously, no touchdown scored in this game.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away.
And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
Yeah, from that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Now Prescott. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing 4-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
Throwing again on second and 10. Prescott. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
A couple of quick incompletions, and now they're just one more away from getting off the field.
They've got options now. Could they dial up a blitz here or just drop everyone into coverage to crowd the throwing lanes?
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Now Prescott. Man open left side is Brown. And he'll be brought down shy of the first down marker at the 11. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and that'll bring up fourth down.
I think that call was made not so much to try and get the first down, although they would have taken it if they could have gotten it, but to give their punter a little bit of space and try and help out their defense.
Yeah, got the safe completion on third. Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over. As San Francisco's offense returns to the field, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD. And if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
On second down, McCaffrey. And the ball is knocked out. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line.
He has been a workhorse for them in this game, and ball security hasn't been an issue until that point.
Yeah, and let's face it, when he's going to carry the ball that many times, he becomes more and more of a target for the defense, knowing that he's going to be the primary guy. They'll just send more and more players towards him, trying to make sure they knock the ball free.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. Prescott now after the fumble recovery.
He'll fire this deep for Gallup.
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Got a man, it's Brown. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll be second down. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. They lose 2 on that last play, so things get even tougher. Third and long coming up.
We'll put that one in the win column for the defense. Trying to contain tight ends in the passing game is so difficult nowadays, but they did in a big way there.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb.
And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
On to punt now, Anger, as he boots this one away.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt.
And they will take over first and 10. San Francisco set to go on offense once more.
Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers. They've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
And every game that's ever been played, all coaches talk about taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one, after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball, and it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard. Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it, but it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
How about that there? No frills, no additives, right? Nothing crazy. Just find a way to pick up the first down. A nice run right there.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Off the option, here's McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 68 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. A 3-yard loss, fourth down now. Before they can get the punt away, whistles as we've come to the end of the third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now here in Santa Clara. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. They'll get this to Jennings over the middle. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
So the fourth down conversion sets him up with this. First and 10 at the 40. Flush to his right. That one tipped and it's incomplete. What good hands there defensively. It's second down.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops from one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Purdy now to throw. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9, and they need 10 yards out of it on third. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Purdy, big fourth down play. And this one is incomplete. Well, that's another mistake there on the drop pass on fourth, and we've seen him do things like this all game.
It's not hard to figure out why they're down by that deficit. They haven't made plays that are going to keep them in the game or win the game all game long. That's another example right there. It all boils down at the end of it to execution. Either you make the play or you don't.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at the 40. He'll hand it off to Elliott to begin the drive.
And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
On second down, Elliott once more. And they'll hold him to three there as he takes this up to the 47.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The offense on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. Off the play fake, Prescott. Open man, Lamb. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Prescott and Lamb hooking up for the Cowboy first.
Partner, I have to tell you, just one word keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon, and that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff, and they haven't let up here even into the fourth quarter.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. 10th carry now for Elliott. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line.
85 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
It's not a huge breakaway run, but if your starting running back finishes the game with averages of 5 or 6 yards per touch, you'll take that every single time.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4.
On the option, here's Elliott.
And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to 3rd down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
On 3rd down, Elliott. And he'll be taken down, but he does have 1st down yardage. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Brandon, this can be so demoralizing for a defense. They've had 2 opportunities to get off the field. They haven't gotten it done. So now your coordinator, he's going to call every blitz that he has, any type of exotic, something that they haven't seen before. And he's also telling the defensive linemen, don't worry about holding people up. Just get in gaps and try and make a big play.
And not only not getting off the field on 2 opportunities, clock continuing to run. A 1st down carry by Elliott. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Again, it's Elliott. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's got to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brandon, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now. And here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
Looking to throw, Prescott. He'll go underneath here to Elliott. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, 1st and 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter,
you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 yards. That sets him up first and goal.
I've got an idea. Let's skip racing to the airport at the end of this game. Let's go to the post-game press conference. I have a feeling that the quarterback of this winning team is going to be giving a whole lot of credit to the running game and the offensive line.
Yeah, I was just going to say the offensive line. Yes, carrying the ball has been key, but those guys up front, they've made a lot of space. Now Elliott, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Marr on for the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers.
Well, I hate to say it, but at this point, I don't really know that they're playing to win with this deficit in the fourth quarter. They're just trying to erase that zero on the scoreboard, Charles, and get some type of momentum to carry into the film session tomorrow.
If you get any type of points on the board, it'll count as a moral victory, although no one will talk about that in the post-game press conference. That's not something you mentioned in the NFL. And this loss, it already stings and will for a while, but everyone on that offense knows it'll sting a lot worse if they don't put some points up on the board.
Ball at the 24 and a second and 11. Purdy with one final shot here. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory.